This is Brian from ActiveMelody.com. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to play Jingle Bell Rock. It's sort of my version of the melody. I wanted to do something that was fun that you could do by yourself with no accompaniment. You can do this on electric or an acoustic, by the way. Although it sounds better on electric, it's a little easier to do on electric because there's some bends and stuff. And it's played pretty high on the neck. One thing I will mention is there is no tablature, there's no jam track with this lesson. I'm trying to respect the original copyright, so for that reason, I didn't include any of that material. So all the material, however, I will break it down and show you how to play everything note for note in this lesson, so you just have to watch the lesson and learn to play it that way. So let's get started. All right, so Jingle Bell Rock is played in the key of D. Or this version is in the key of D, and that the first thing that happens is that defining electric guitar riff, which really defines the song, which is, and the way that that's played, the first part of that little intro, is the way I do it is I take my pointer finger and I come up here and I bar the first two strings on the 14th fret. That's sort of mentally where I go with it. But then once I bar that, I go ahead and put my middle finger down on the 15th fret second string to play that note. So what I'm playing are the first two strings, and that's the first thing that happens. So it's, and I kind of slide into that. You don't have to. I've heard it played either way, but that's what you're trying to play are those two notes. Now the second time, I release my middle finger so that I've got just the bar on the 14th fret, first two strings. And then I go ahead and push back down on the 15th fret, second string, so that I can play that just once. Then I take my pinky and I come up here and grab the 17th fret, first string. And so what I'm doing there is the two notes that I'm playing are the 17th fret first string and the 15th fret second string. But keep in mind or notice that I keep that bar down, that bar in the 14th fret, that stays down the whole time for that first part of the intro there. So if you watch, I'll play it slowly. See, the bar just kind of stays in place. Okay, now after that, what I do is I come down and play. And this is going to be a little bit challenging doing the bend because you're bending the first two strings there. But what I do is I take that bar that I'm doing normally there on the 14th fret, come down to the 10th fret, again just playing the first two strings. So just like that. Then I'm going to take my middle finger and my ring finger and I'm going to push both of them down on the 12th fret, strings 1 and 2, so that I can bend sort of a half bend on the 12th fret there. So after I bar the 10th fret with my pointer finger, I take my middle finger, ring finger, both on the 12th fret, and play the 12th fret, and then the second time I play it, I do this kind of real twangy bend where I'm actually bending both of those strings. So you're bending the second string and the first string. But you're doing it at the same time, so it sounds like this. Now, if you're trying this on an acoustic guitar, you can do that. Hopefully, you've got a cutaway on neck, or you've got enough room on the fretboard. But you can do this on an acoustic as well. It's just going to be a little more challenging. But and so, what you do is after you do that bend, you release it, come back to the 12th fret where you started, and then back to the 10th fret. So let's play all of that. I'll play it slowly, just as a reference here. So here's how that first part sounds. Okay, and then after that, I take my ring finger and I come down and I bar the 12th fret, the first three strings, but I'm only going to play strings 2 and 3. So that I got those two strings. So that's strings 3 and 2, barred on the 12th fret. And then I come down and I do this little little hammer-on thing there. And so what I'm doing there is, so I go from barring the first three strings on the 12th fret to barring the first three strings on the 10th fret with my pointer finger. Again, I'm playing strings 2 and 3, those two. Then I hammer on my middle finger, I hammer that down on the 11th fret third string like this. So that it completes that D chord. But I do it kind of quickly like that. So. Okay. And so what I played, since I don't have any accompanying music, is I played. And all I did there was, after I hammer on my middle finger there on the 11th fret, third string, I take my ring finger, put it down on the fourth string, 12th fret, keeping the bar there on the first three strings. I'll just come up there and I hit the first string on the 10th fret. So it's almost an octave. And really that's that D chord. If you think of if you play a D bar chord, what I'm doing there is I'm playing those first, four notes out of that, or first four strings out of that D bar chord. So here it is slowly again. Okay, and then I come and do the little bass walk down, which is. And that's actually pretty easy to do. All we do is it's all played on the sixth string. It starts here on the fifth fret. Then I walk down to the third fret, sixth string. Then to the second fret, sixth string. And then just the open sixth string. So it sounds like this. And I'm using a little palm muting with my right hand. Palm muting is when you put your palm down and rest it on the strings. It gives you a little more of a, almost sounds like a bass guitar. If you don't palm mute, it sounds like this. When you do, it sounds like this. Just kind of a cooler effect. Again, it's just resting the palm of your hand, the sort of meaty part of your palm, just resting it on the strings to get that effect. Okay? Now, I come in and I play the melody, and so the first thing that happens is, and notice the rhythm pattern is just down, up, down for this. And what I'm playing there is I'm playing really the top part of that. If you think of the D bar chord, D major bar chord, normally you wouldn't play that bar chord because it's pretty high on the neck, but what I'm doing is I'm playing. I'm barring the first two strings on fret 10, and then I'm putting my middle finger down on the 11th fret third string. And so that's the first three notes I'm playing. Okay, and that's a D chord. It's just a D chord played very highly on the neck. Highly, is that a word? I don't think so. So anyway, that's the first thing that happens. Then I play. And what that is that's an F sharp minor chord, I believe, played again high on the neck. But what I'm doing there to make that chord is I'm pushing down on the 9th fret first string with my pointer finger, the 10th fret second string with my middle finger, and 11th fret third string with my ring finger, and I'm playing those top three strings, and it sounds like this. Okay? So the D chord, and then this F sharp minor chord. And then I come down and I play. And for that, it's actually pretty easy because all I do is I bar the first two strings on the 7th fret, and that's what I'm playing. Then I take my pinky finger. You could do this with, it probably makes more sense to do it with your ring finger, but it's just a habit of me to use my, for me to use my pinky for these kinds of stretches. But what I do is I play the 9th fret first string. So I play. Okay, so thus far we have. And that's just played on the first two strings, strings 1 and 2, barring on the 7th fret, pushing down on the 9th fret, first string. And then we play that. And so that is strings 2 and 3, but barring, again, continuing the bar on the 7th fret. So we're just barring, this time we're barring the first three strings. But we're fretting both of those on the 7th fret. So that time we're playing strings 2 and 3. So all together it's like this. Okay, and that's defined the first part of the melody. Then we come back and there's some repetition here. I play. We just did that. Again, you know, that's the barring the first two strings on the 7th fret, playing up here on the 9th fret. Then I play this really cool diminished chord. So, and what I'm doing there is I'm barring the 5th fret with my pointer finger, and I'm pushing down on the 7th fret 2nd string with my pinky, and the 7th fret 4th string with my ring finger to create. And when I play that, I'm really only playing I'm really only playing strings 5, 4, 3, and 2. And sometimes I don't have time to play because it happens really quickly. So sometimes I only play strings 4, 3, and 2. But that's the effect you're trying to get. So, and so that's the first part of the melody, is to play the bottom, or strings 5, 4, 3, and 2. But then the second part of that little melody is I'm just playing string 1, and again it's all part of this bar here on the 5th fret. So it's slowly, and you'll get this when you hear it in references. And notice when I'm playing that first string there on barred on the 5th fret, I'm just doing an upstroke with the right hand. So it's a downstroke to define that part of the melody, an upstroke for that part of the melody, in just one single string. And then I come up and I play this minor chord here. And what I'm doing there is, it's an E minor chord, but it's just played higher on the neck. It's very similar to that F sharp minor chord that we just played at the beginning. But this time we're playing it down here. So first, pointer finger is on the first string, 7th fret. Middle finger is on the 8th string, 2nd fret. I'm sorry, the 8th fret, 2nd string. And the my ring finger is on the 9th fret, 3rd string, to play the E minor chord like that. And you're just playing those top three strings. So that's the effect. And then while I've got that, all I have to do is push down with my pinky here on the 9th fret first string to get that part of the melody. You can see my pinky going down. Okay, so I think it's probably worth backing up and playing everything kind of slowly, just so you get the melody. So here's what we have. Okay, so there's that E minor. Now I come down all the way down to first position and play this A seventh chord. And the way that I do it is I just bar the first four strings on fret two with my pointer finger, and I take my ring finger and push down on the third fret first string to play that A seventh. And then we come to this part. And that's the part that repeats, and it's actually pretty easy to do because all you're playing is just the first three strings. It's really an E minor chord, but you're not making the whole chord. You're just playing the first three strings, so you don't have to actually fret anything for the first part. Now I'm going to fret the second fret on the first string, then the third fret on the first string. So we have. Just like that. And then I'm going to come up here and play. And what I'm playing here is an A. It's an A major chord. And to make that chord, I'm just barring. It's just the same as if you're playing an F, if you learn to play an F in the first position. You're playing that same shape, but you're doing it up here so that you're barring the first two strings on the fifth fret instead of the first. But first two strings on the fifth fret are barred. Then I take my middle finger, push down on the sixth fret third string, and then I take my ring finger and push down on the seventh fret fourth string. It gives me that A major chord. So the first part of that is the first three strings on that are open. Then we come up and play the A. Notice what I'm going to do with my pinky again. I'm going to come up here and push my pinky down on the seventh fret first string to play that. So back down to here. And that may be challenging for you to jump back and forth between that. But just practice it over and over again and you'll get it. And if this whole song is, don't try and play it up to tempo in the beginning. Just try and get it where you can do it accurate. And there's nothing wrong with playing it. Playing it slowly like that. That would be fun. So, in fact, let me do that. Let me play it slowly up to where we're at. There's that A seventh. Now we're going to do the open string. A, E minor, A. Now we're going to come back and play the E minor up here again. And remember, that's one where I'm fretting it 7th fret 1st string, 8th fret 2nd string, 9th fret 3rd string. We're just playing the top three strings there. And then I come down and play this really cool chord. And I love that chord. I'll have to think of the name of it here in a minute. But it's one that you hear. There's a famous Beatles song that starts with that chord. But anyway, I won't mention that in this one. But to make the chord, The way that I think of this chord is when you think of an A minor, the shape that you make when you learn an A minor down in first position, you're kind of making that same shape, but instead of when you make an A minor, typically your pointer finger's on the second string. In this case, however, we're going to do it up here. We're going to do it in a different position, but you take that same shape as if you were making an A minor, but instead of on the second string, you're starting here on the first string. So it's the first string, fifth fret, with your pointer finger, and then you take your ring finger and come down to the sixth fret, second string, and then I take my middle finger and come to the sixth fret, third string, and so I play that little shape. Okay, and that's what makes it sound different. Obviously, in A minor, again, everything is jumped down a string, but that's the shape that I think of. And the only missing string that you have to fill in here is you take your pinky and you come to the seventh fret, fourth string to push down. And when you play those first four strings, they'll sound like this. So very cool chord, but that's kind of a transition chord. It's a type of chord that you would use to maybe start a song or transition from one part to another. That's kind of how I think of that, using that chord. And again, it's something you hear, not too often, but you hear it in some songs. So, okay, so. Here's the A7th. Now we come back to this E minor. And here's that new chord. Okay, now, that's really all there is to the first part of that. And obviously, then it repeats. It comes back. This time, here's the difference, is we come to a major chord. And that chord, by the way, is a G chord. But I'm playing it using the D shape. So when we think of a D down in first position, that's if you make that D and you just slide everything up so that your pointer finger and your middle finger are actually on the seventh fret, that's the shape that we're making. So as a reference, to break it apart, it's seventh fret first string with your middle finger. Then your ring finger comes to the eighth fret second string. And your pointer finger comes back to the seventh fret, but this time on the third string. And so you're playing those three strings to get that chord. And that's a G chord, just played at a higher position. And when I play it, I kind of play a little vibrato. Or actually, you know what? I kind of picked it apart. And you're probably thinking, well, what part is that in the song? This is the second time through. There it is. Okay, and then we come to the... I love that. And really, what we're doing here is, that's actually still a G chord, believe it or not. See, there's a G. But this time we're switching, so we just played it here. Now we're going to play a G chord by pushing down on the on strings 2 and 3 on the 12th fret, and I'm using my ring finger and middle finger for that. And then I take my pointer finger and push down on the 10th fret first string. And those three strings give you a G chord in this position on the neck. So it's kind of cool when you think about it. You can play a G here, you can play a G here, you can play a G here, you can play a G down here like you know in first position. So you start to see, really all I'm doing to create this melody is I'm just taking chords and I'm shifting them into different positions on the neck. So that's what this is. And what I'm doing there is I'm playing, let me play it slowly. So it's strings 2 and 3, then string 1, string 2. Then I take my pinky and I come up here on the 12th fret first string. See how it's kind of sliding in there? And I go... And notice that's just a pull-off. So this all stays in place. The only thing that's moving here or changing is the pinky. So the pinky goes down right there. It pulls off, and to pull off, all you do is you kind of flick the string with your finger as you release it. So. And then the second time through, I play the G minor, which is. And for that chord, I'm just switching. The only thing that I'm really doing is I'm switching position here. My pointer finger stays down the whole time. It stays down on the 10th fret first string. But then I release my middle finger and my ring finger, and that to play the G minor chord in that same position. All I do is I move them so that my middle finger is on the 11th fret second string, and then my ring finger is on the 12th fret third string, and you get this sound. You can hear it's a minor. Notice that's the same shape when we played the F sharp minor. Same shape there. When we played the E minor down here, now we're playing it up here, and we're getting a G minor. So just using those three top three strings in that shape, you can play minor chords. You know, and you wouldn't normally play. I mean, it's not a very full sounding chord, but if you're playing a melody style like this, that's more than enough to kind of be able to harmonize with yourself and give context around the chord. So. So again, let me do that slowly. So here's the G part. So it's strings 2 and 3, and then string 1, string 2, string 1, pull off, string 2, okay? And now we switch to the G minor shape. Strings 2 and 3, string 1, string 2, and again, I push my pinky down on the 12th fret first string. So. And that's kind of. Okay, and then I come down and play this. And to do that, all I'm doing is I'm sliding into this chord, and really, it's if you think of an A7th, the A7th that we learned down here just a minute ago, where we're barring the second fret, and then pushing down on the third fret first string. Same concept, but slid up here so that this time I'm barring the ninth fret, first three strings on the ninth fret, and I'm pushing down with my. You can use your ring finger or your middle finger, whichever's easiest, or your pinky if that's easiest, but I'm pushing down on the 10th fret first string with that finger. That creates that 7th chord. And then I play that chord. And that again is just that D shape. This time my middle finger goes down on the 9th fret first string. My ring finger goes down on the 10th fret second string, and my pointer finger goes down on the 9th fret third string to play that D shape here. So it's. And then back to the D, which is how we started it. Okay. All right, so let me play everything through. I'll play it kind of slowly up to this point. Thank you. Okay, so then we come to the bridge of the song, if you will, and the bridge part goes. Like that. So the first thing that happens is that G part, which we've already done this. So this is just playing the G up here with the pinky, which we've done already. So again, that's pointer finger down on the 10th fret first string, ring finger down on the 12th fret second string, middle finger down on the 12th fret third string. And then I'm pushing down with my pinky on the 12th fret first string, releasing it. And then I play this chord. Again, both of those are playing just the top three strings. So those are the only strings we're worried about. This time I'm playing a D7th shape. This is how I think of it. And then I push down with my pinky to get that part. But the D7th shape, if you learn a D7th down in first position, same shape, but played right here. So what I'm doing is I'm putting my ring finger down on the 10th fret first string. I'm putting my pointer finger down on the 9th fret second string. And then I'm putting my middle finger down on the 10th fret third string to play the D7th chord. But then once that chord is in place, I take my pinky and I come up here and play the first string on the 12th fret so that I have this. And so I can do that, and then I can release the pinky to get that effect. So the first time through, it sounds like this. Then we come to that chord. And then I played something like this. And what I'm doing there is I'm just playing, it's back to that D chord, which is how we started. I'm only playing, but I'm kind of hammering on, just like we did at one point earlier. So I'm kind of barring the 10th fret, and then I'm playing string 3, barring on to the 11th fret, string 3. That's the 10th fret first string. Then I come down and play the 9th fret first string. So it's like that. Then I'm going to reach up and play the 12th fret 2nd string. Then the 10th fret 2nd string. So. And then I played. And to do that, I'm just repeating that, how I started it. Again, it's just the hammer on there. Hammering on to the 11th fret 3rd string. Then I'm going to take my ring finger and come down to the 12th fret 4th string. And then that puts me in position to take my pointer finger and come down and hit the 5th string 10th fret. And then I just slide down one to the 9th fret on the 5th string. So it goes. Okay, so altogether that part is. Let me do it slower. Okay, and then I play this little. This is a 7th chord here. That same 7th chord you did a minute ago. Again, it's barring the 9th fret, the first three strings, with your pointer finger, and then taking your, I take my ring finger and push down on the 10th fret first string. it allows me to take my pinky, come up here and grab the 12th fret first string, and then release it, then take my pinky and push it back down on the 12th fret, this time on the second string. So that's string 2, string 1. Keep that 7th chord the whole time. Notice that this never moves. The bar always stays, and then my ring finger here on the 10th fret first string always stays. The only thing that's really moving is my pinky, and it's jumping from string 1 to string 2 on the 12th fret. And then I played this little thing that goes. And I do that a little different every time. There's all kinds of ways you can do it, but I'm just kind of sliding into. I'm really jumping between strings 3 and 1, so I'm only playing strings 3 and 1. And what I'm doing there is, that's just, think of an A chord. It's just strings 3 and 1 from the A chord, but. My middle finger is on the 6th fret, 3rd string, and my pointer finger is on the 5th fret, 1st string. And now I'm straddling the 7th fret. Both fingers here, both my middle finger and ring finger are on the 7th fret, but they're on strings 3 and 1. So it's... And keep in mind, this shape, I keep this shape the whole time. So really, it's pretty easy. Well, all you're learning are those two shapes. If that's one shape, that's the other one. Again, it's between strings 3 and 1. Those are the only two strings I'm playing for this part. And when I switch to this, they're both straddling the same fret. So that's fret 7, fret 8. Fret 9, back to 8, back to 7, and then back to that first little pattern. Okay, so let's slowly play that bridge part up to that point. Now, really it comes back and repeats. There's nothing that you haven't learned at this point. There's that major chord. And then we come back and repeat this. Seventh chord, back to that major chord, and then to end it, I just repeated the intro part again and went. The only difference is that final chord. I played the sort of that D13 chord, and to play that 13 chord, I'm just barring the 10th fret, and then I'm. Here's the easiest way to do it. Think of playing a D major chord. So let's start there with a D major chord. And to do that, I'm going to bar the 10th fret. And then I'm going to put my middle finger down on the 3rd string, 11th fret. My pinky goes down on the 12th fret, 4th string. And my ring finger goes down on the... 5th string, 12th fret. So so with that with the bar, that's a D major bar chord. So the same as if you're playing an E. Think of playing an E down here in the first position. The nut here, this little white thing, that's your bar. Obviously, when you're making a bar chord, you're simulating that nut and you're moving it up the neck. So that's what's happening there for the D major. Now to make it a 13th, I just take my pinky, keep the shape, but just remove my pinky and push it down on the 12th fret second string. So it sounds like that. So you're creating that note. It's just a nice little way to end it. So. Just like that. And that's Jingle Bell Rock played with a melody all by yourself. You can do that with accompaniment, or you can do it by yourself. Well, that's it for this lesson. So thanks for watching. Be sure to like me over at Facebook if you haven't done so already. It's facebook.com/activemelody. Or you can follow me on Twitter. It's twitter.com/activemelody. Hope everyone has a wonderful and Merry Christmas, and we'll see you in the next lesson.